Welkom terug weer groot by Wat 'n Lekker Likkie, Let Me Matthew Mole. Maar die vibe gaan ons nou kiel met so 'n bietjie gesels oor misdaad, Elsa.
Dankie Jorna. Ja, die skrywer, die potgooier en blogger Nicole Engelbrecht kuier vanoggend saam om oor die jongste misdaadsyfers in Suid-Afrika te gesels. So Nicole, thank you so much for joining us this morning and welcome to die Groot Ontbyt.
Thank you so much. I appreciate you having me on.
Nicole, I would just like to start with your background. I mean, do you mainly focus on crime when it comes to research and your blogging, etc.?
Yes, so that is certainly my main area of interest, is crime in South Africa, particularly violent crime. So that's the area that I focus my interest on, and in my writing, and of course my podcast as well, is violent crime in South Africa particularly.
Okay, now let's refer to this interesting, I would rather add, concerning stats and, you know, the latest information regarding the different countries. I mean, especially if you take a look at South Africa, 6 cities that top this list. Sure. Just give us some background regarding this research and the latest stats.
Okay. So I think it's very important for us to understand the context of that IOL article and the index that those statistics come from and the nature of it. Because the Numbeo index that they refer to there, that puts 6 South African cities in the top 20 in the world's dangerous cities, is actually based on perception. So it's not an index that's based on crime statistics. It's based on visitors to the Numbeo website and their perceptions of how dangerous various cities in the world are. So I think that's the first thing we need to understand. You know, obviously there's a big difference between someone's perception of something and the actual, the true facts behind it.
Definitely.
Yeah. So, you know, if we look at it, there is still value in the index.
I'm going to interrupt you there for a second because sure. I want to ask you, I mean, how credible are these figures then?
Well, they're credible to the extent that the people that have visited the website have given their honest perceptions. But are they credible in terms of whether these are actually the 6 most dangerous cities in the world? No, we cannot say that. You know, there are other indexes, which I can discuss if you'd like me to, that probably paints a more accurate picture of where South African cities sits in the sort of an international crime arena, if we'd like to put it that way.
Okay, yes, let's take a look at those findings.
Okay, so we have another index that I looked at, which is called the Statista Index. And they base their index on crime statistics. So that's number-based, fact-based. And on that index, the most recent one was done in 2020. And in the top 20 there, South Africa has one city featuring, and that is Cape Town, at position 14, I believe. So that does give you an indication of, you know, perhaps the, you know, the reality behind statistics. But again, statistics internationally are, you know, very difficult to compare because all countries deal with crime differently. All countries have different types of crime, different types of policing. So that is the reality behind the statistic-based index.
Nicole, it's your name, yeah? And I'm not one of those people. I hate fake news or even if it's not real fake news because it was still, people that said that's how they feel, the perceptions. But a headline would say, Pretoria now 9th dangerous city in the world. And that was like the headline. And I was one of the suckers that at least 2 braais, I said to people, you know, we're living now in the 3rd most dangerous city. So I look like...
He's on?
Yeah, you see. And I think that's so... It's very important then for media to... Especially with headlines, because I fell for this one, you know? And you spread kind of rumors. It's very important
exactly.
to, when it comes to crime, to really have the right statistics.
Well, yes, and we'll continue with this discussion. I'm so sorry, Nicole, but I'm going to interrupt you there. Right after the news, we'll continue with this interesting discussion.
Jy kan ons laat weet op Facebook en op Twitter, Groot FM 90.5. Waar voel jy die veiligste? En Elsa, dit is natuurlijk na aanleiding van die gesprek wat ons vandag ook het.
Ja, ek dink 'n mens moet weer eens verwys na die feit dat hierdie inligting glo net gebaseer is op persepsies. En jy weet, dit kan baie maklik verkeerlik opgeneem word, as 'n mens dit so kan stel en versprei word. Maar ja, ek dink op die einde van die dag, dis miskien een van die vrae waarby ons wel moet uitkom, is om te vra, jy weet, kan dit wel beskou word as iets soos fopnuus, wanneer 'n mens hierdie inligting versprei, selfs al is dit gebaseer, of word dit gebaseer op persepsies, of is daar 'n mate van geloofwaardigheid wat steeds hier rol vertolk?
En dalk net om duidelik te maak, vir die wat dalk nou ingeskakel het, radio of TV gewys, dit is dan nou statistiek met verwysing na misdaad.
Ja, of net die verskillende stede of lande wat die gevaarlikste is, en dalk net 'n bietjie meer agtergrond. Ek dink voordat die mense aangaan met hierdie gesprek, wil ek net noem dat volgens hierdie lys is daar nou 6 stede wat uitgesonder is in Suid-Afrika, waarvan Pretoria in die derde plek op hierdie lys lê. Dit is nou 'n top 20. Durban, vierde, in die vyfde plek Johannesburg, dan in die sewende plek sien ek Pietermaritzburg, in die 14de plek Port Elizabeth, en in die 19de plek Kaapstad, so 6 stede in Suid-Afrika wat hierdie lys gehaal het, gegrond op persepsies dan nou, en ek neem aan dis wêreldwyd, maar ons gaan nou uitvind, want ons gaan voort met vanoggend se gesprek met die skrywer, die potgooier en blogger, Nicole Engelbrecht, wat saamkuier, om dan nou oor hierdie inligting te gesels. Nicole, thanks again for joining us this morning.
Hello, yes, you gotta love technology, hey, but I am back.
Absolutely, no, we are so glad to hear that. I want to continue with what Jorna said a little bit earlier. Can one consider the distribution of these types of figures as fake news, given the fact that they are based on perceptions?
No. So I wouldn't say that. It's certainly not. There is value to it. There's value in the context that it comes from people's opinions and it comes from people's perceptions. Mm-hmm. But those perceptions come from somewhere. And I think if we ask ourselves, where do those perceptions come from? That gives us maybe a better idea of the actual value of the index.
Absolutely.
Because there's a reason that people have that perception about, those 6 cities in question and maybe our country in general.
Mm-hmm. Now, was this information collected using a poll, and how many people participated in this research? Do you have that information?
So I looked at the Numbeo website, and they didn't give a lot of information about how many people participated. They did say that the structure of the survey was very similar to most government surveys. And they did say that they only used data where there was sufficient responses. Interesting thing that they didn't say that I found quite vital to understanding it is whether all of these responses were from citizens of those cities or if they were from anyone across the world. Because I think that would also be an interesting perception. People internationally have these idea of our cities, or is it just the people that actually live there?
Mm-hmm. And Nicole, is there anything else? I mean, if you take a look and perhaps summarize this informational figures in essence, what would you point out in terms of what you find the most interesting?
So I think the biggest value that we can get from this index, and also comparing it to the Statista index, which gives us actual crime statistics, is noting that there are certain factors that all of the cities in the top 20 across the world have in common. And those factors are high unemployment rates, high poverty rates, and high drug and alcohol abuse rates. So that, for me, is very interesting. Mm-hmm. Because those are, if we use these perceptions to understand some of the factors that are actually promulgating crime in these cities, then at least we have an area to start focusing on. And look, we need to also look at, you know, is someone's perception of danger losing your life, or is their perception of danger losing their cell phone? Because those are two very different crimes and two very different levels of concern. So I certainly think there is value in it, absolutely. But we need to be a bit more broad-minded about it and take it in context in order to get value out of it.
Well, all I can say is let's hope that some of these necessary authorities, you know, give attention to how people feel about South Africa in general. And like you said, you know, pay attention rather and investigate it a little bit more to come up with some solutions as well. But Nicole, thank you so much for your time. That was Nicole Engelbrecht van True Crime South Africa.